So, the M1X chipset is looking to be a beast. Today I want to talk about the Apple Silicon chipset M1X Core Amounts for the CPU and GPU and what this means compared to M1. Let's go into more details about this and also a summary of everything we know so far, including the MacBook Pro M1X release date and price. Hi, it's Matt here, and we are now at the end of September. So as it's getting closer to the MacBook Pro's release date and more leaks and reports are dropping in more regularly, I am making more MacBook Pro 14 and 16 inch videos until its launch. So as I've said before, I've decided for all the new MacBook Pro M1X videos like this one you are watching, I'm going to give you the latest details on specific reports of info that we've been told, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the models that are going to be released with all their features that we've learnt in previous leaks. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list, as it were, for the MacBook Pro 14 inch, and also put in the comments below of what features you would like to see in the new MacBook Pros, and maybe in my next video I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So let's get started with that report about the power of M1X and what to expect. So we have had a report earlier this year with the potential of what the M1X will have inside compared to M1. So the report says that M1X is to be equipped with 10 CPU cores. Right now with M1 we actually have 8 cores, so right away you're thinking, 2 extra cores, how can that be amazing compared to M1? Well, it's because the cores will be aligned differently to M1. The M1 chipset has 8 cores made up of 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores. However, for M1X, we're being told we're going to be getting 2 efficiency cores and 8 performance cores. So right away, with just the performance cores, we'll be getting a 100% increase in the amount of cores. Now it does mean less efficiency cores, but M1X MacBook Pros will be designed for creators and developer apps out there. The efficiency cores will be more for light browsing on the internet or taking notes, for example. For GPU cores, again, M1 has 8 GPU cores. However, we're being told for M1X we'll be actually getting 16 to 32 GPU cores, and this will be a massive increase in graphics power for 3D animators, video and photo editors out there. M1X, or whatever the new Apple Silicon chipset will be called because the name isn't 100% confirmed yet, is looking to be a powerhouse that is looking to set a pro laptop benchmark for many years to come in the laptop industry. However, I will comment that this also leads me on to say that all reports and leaks are not 100% proof that they will come true for new MacBooks. Like I said at the beginning of this video, I can only present to you what I've been told and shown. However, if you are still watching this video, then you are as curious as I am in knowing what is being said about the new MacBooks anyway. So, continuing on with the release date. So, based on Mark Gurman's recent report saying that the MacBook Pros are coming in several weeks, this is most likely going to be the case for a launch event in October and release around a week or so later. Remember, the last time we got an overall design refresh on the MacBook Pros was in October 2016. So, there's a possibility for this. But the exact date, with the exception of the COVID launches in 2020 of the new M1 Max, all previous full releases of MacBooks have come at the end of October, and this has always been in the mid-20 numbers or even the first or second day into November, and it's always been a Friday. In fact, another leaker, Dylan, has also said that the end of October or early November time is on the cards. So based on this info, and remember this is on facts of other full-time MacBook releases, so remember this is not written in stone, we could, and I'll say that again, could see the new MacBooks in our hands on October 22nd or October 29th. But if we get a firm date, this of course will change, but for now this gives you a good time to base on when the release will be. So, just quickly, this channel has just hit over 230,000 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing. And we did a giveaway of a MacBook Pro M1. Well, I've got you some great news, guys. We're doing another giveaway, and it is for this. It is for an iPad Pro M1 with 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Now, anybody can enter in to win this giveaway around the world. It is an international giveaway. But all I want to know from you guys is basically, what Apple tech are you planning to buy in 2021? Or what other tech are you planning to buy if it's not going to be Apple tech? Write it down in the comments below, and make sure at the same time as well to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, I'm going to be revealing who the winner is of this iPad Pro. So make sure you do that right now, because you'll want to know if you're going to be the lucky person to get your hands on this iPad Pro. Also at the same time as well, if you're enjoying this video so far, please make sure to press the like button. Well, let's get back to the video. With the latest leaks and release date out of the way, let's move on to a summary of everything we know so far. That previous leaks have painted a picture of the details for the MacBook Pro 14-inch and 16-inch with their price as well. So it's possible that what you're seeing here is going to change over the next coming weeks or months as we get more leaks and reports coming in. But let's begin. So the new MacBook Pro 14-inch is most likely going to be getting that brand new XDR liquid retina display like what we get inside the iPad Pro right now. It will be a mini LED display, and with that we'll be getting a resolution of around 2752 by 1720. And also, if it's like the XDR liquid retina display that exists right now, like in the iPad Pro 12.9 inch, it will also come with a ProMotion display, what means it will have a 120 hertz refresh rate. For storage options, it will start at 512 gigabytes and go all the way up to 4 terabytes. For the actual chipset inside it, it is looking likely that we're probably going to be getting an M1X chipset inside, and this will be a 10 core CPU setup, and this will give us 8 performance cores and 2 efficiency cores, and then there will be an option between a 16 and a 32 core GPU depending on how much RAM you pick. And talking about RAM, there's going to be a choice between 16 to 64 gigabytes of RAM, and it's seeming likely that if you do pick the 32 gigabytes or the 64 gigabyte RAM option, this will give you the 32 core GPU option. There's also going to be a brand new design, because at the end of the day we're increasing up to a 14-inch design, and it's all going to look completely different. We're going to have an aluminium body, what MacBook Pros have been made out for many years. For ports wise, we're going to be getting the MagSafe. It's going to be returning at last in a brand new way, so it's really exciting to see to come back to the MacBook Pros, because it's a great port. We're also going to be getting 3 USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports will also be USB 4 compatible, and we're also going to be getting return of a HDMI port, will be HDMI 2.1, and also an SD card port as well. That's going to be returning back to the MacBook Pro. For the actual webcam, we're going to be getting that center stage webcam like we get on the new iPad Pros right now, and this is a 12 megapixel camera in the middle of your MacBook Pro. For battery life, we're expected to be getting a 6,068 milliamp battery inside it, so that should give us a really good battery life, especially mixed with the brand new Apple Silicon chipset. So prices wise, these are based on the lowest spec MacBook Pro 14-inch that you can get, because you can choose the different kind of storage options and RAMs and bits and pieces. All the prices sort of change. So I've just basically based all the prices on 16 gigs of RAM and then going up with the storages. So starting with the 512 gigabyte of storage, it will start at $1,799. 1 terabyte will be $1,999. 2 terabytes at $2,399, and 4 terabytes at $2,999. Moving on to the 16-inch MacBook Pro, we're expecting a 16-inch XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display. This is very similar to the display that we find in the iPad Pro 12.9-inch, and it will feature a resolution of 3072 by 1920, exactly what we get in the standard LED display in the current MacBook Pro 16-inch. However, the difference is most likely we're going to be getting ProMotion 120 hertz refresh rate with this. On top for storage options, they will start from 512GB all the way up to 8TB of storage. Then most likely we're going to be getting our M1X chipset inside it, which will be a 12-core CPU and also will feature a 16 or 32-core GPU option depending on the amount of RAM that you pick. And talk about RAM, the options of RAMs will be 16GB, 32GB or 64GB of RAM. It is most likely that the 32-core GPU option will be available with 32 or 64GB of RAM. We're also going to be getting a brand new design with the MacBook Pro 16-inch, and it will be made out of an aluminium body. And you've seen this new design and what it could potentially look like in the renders in this video. For ports, MagSafe is back at last, but at the same time as well, we'll be getting 3 USB-C ports, and these will be Thunderbolt 4 ports, so that's one less than what we get on the MacBook Pro right now. But we will get the return of HDMI 2.1 and also an SD card slot. At the same time, the webcam in the center is going to be that new center stage webcam that will be a 12 megapixel camera. The battery life from the latest leaks that we've been told will be an 8,693 milliamp. So for prices, because things can be a bit of a mix-up depending on what options you pick, I've based this on the lowest amount of RAM, what you can get, and then going up in storage amounts. So the prices will start at $2,399 for a 512GB option. For 1TB, $2,099. 2TB, $2,999. 4TB, $3,599. And 8TB, $4,799. So that is a summary of the MacBook Pro 14-inch. However, for my thoughts and wishes. So my main wish is basically the same for the 16-inch MacBook Pro, and it's to do with the actual price. Now, over the years, the 13-inch MacBook Pro, so this is what we've got right now, including the higher tier version of the 13-inch model, has gone up and creeped up in price quite a bit. The higher tier 13-inch model right now, what they still sell from Apple, starts at $1,800. And if we go back about 8 years ago or so, it starts at $1,400. And I'm just hoping that Apple can at least keep the same price this year round for this brand new MacBook Pro and not increase the price for this next generation. But let me know in your thoughts below if you agree with this or not, and write in the comments as well what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Pro 14-inch. Well guys, it's also time to wrap up this video, so if you've enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, see you soon.